गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, अवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन. ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस डिस्कस सम ऑब्जर्वेशंस इन अवर डेली लाइफ. व्हेन यू वॉक, व्हाट डू? यू पुश द फ्लोर इन बैकवर्ड डायरेक्शन, बट स्टिल यू आर मूविंग इन फॉरवर्ड डायरेक्शन. इट्स इंटरेस्टिंग that you are applying force in backward direction on the floor. Then how you are moving in forward direction? In the same way, when you swim, you push water in backward, but your movement in forward. Or when a gun fires a bullet, you observe that the gun is coming in backward direction. Also, when rocket goes in upward direction, how it goes in upward direction? You see that gases are coming in downward direction. Then how all these phenomena are happening? Today we are going to discuss in Newton's third law of motion, that we can explain these all actions, all these phenomena on the basis of Newton's third law of motion. Let us discuss Newton's third law of motion, how we can define it. The third law of motion states that to every action there is an equal and opposite reaction. Or we can also define it that when one object exerts a force on another object, the second object exerts a force back on the first object. You always have observed, and it's interesting that when you push a ball, then you feel a backward force. So this is Newton's third law of motion, that when one object is applying force on another object, then same force is applied by the another object on the first object. These two forces are always equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. As we discussed pushing a ball, if we are applying 10 Newton force on the wall, then the wall is also applying 10 Newton force on us. But the wall is applying force in opposite direction. So we will take it as minus 10 Newton. As in previous lectures we discussed that force is a vector quantity. Okay, students, you must have observed, if you hit a wall, more harder you hit the wall and more force you feel on your hand, more you will get hurt. Why it happens? Because whatever force you are applying on the wall, it is reverting back to you. If you are hitting the wall with a smaller force, then the force applied by wall on your hand is also smaller. And if you are hitting this wall with a larger force, then a larger force is coming back to you. So students, these forces which you are applying is known as action force, and other force which wall is applying to you, which wall is applying on us, that is reaction force. So always in all the phenomena we discussed earlier also, if one object is applying force on another object, that force is known as action force. And that object is applying force on first object, that is known as reaction force. So we can say that there is a pair of forces and not just one force. So we can say here that single force never exists. force always exists in pairs. So there can be a question that which Newton's law tells us that forces acts always in pairs. So answer will be Newton's third law. Okay, as action and reaction forces are equal and opposite. Now question arises that why these do not cancel each other? Means if we are applying force on any object and that object is also applying same force on us in opposite direction, then why these do not cancel each other? Why there cannot be effect is zero? So answer is, this is because these forces act on different objects and never on the same object. If all the forces are acting on the same object, then if some force is acting in one direction and on the same object, if that force is acting in opposite direction, then that will cancel each other. Like we discussed in balanced forces, that a single object was pushed by two students. One was pushing that object in one direction and the other child or student was pushing that in opposite direction. Both were applying force on the same object, but those forces were equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. But both forces were acting on a single object. So the object was not moving. The object remained at the rest. In balanced force, we discussed about it, that if a lot of forces are acting on an object and if they all are acting on a single object and they are balancing each other, then object will not move. Object will move in the presence of unbalanced force. So don't get confused with this concept that if action and reaction forces, these are acting on different objects, then they cannot cancel each other. This is the main thing. Here Newton's third law of motion acts. Okay, let us discuss some examples based on Newton's third law of motion. First, as we discussed in the starting, walking of a person. The case is that we are applying force on the floor in backward, then how we are moving in forward direction? Yes, this can be explained on the basis of Newton's third law of motion. We are applying force on ground, that is action force, in backward direction, but according to Newton's third law of motion, reaction force is generated on our body, on our feet, in forward direction. Action, reaction, and due to this reaction force we move in forward direction. Next is the firing from a gun. Okay, now when we fire a bullet from the gun, bullet is going in forward direction. How bullet is going in forward direction? Because this gun is applying force on the bullet. Due to that force, bullet is going in forward direction. And as here is action, this is action force. So according to Newton's third law of motion, there will be a reaction force in backward direction. So what happens? What you observe? That this gun will come back. When bullet is fired, gun is coming back. And this coming of gun in backward direction is termed as recoil of gun. So question can be there that why recoil in gun is produced when a bullet is fired from this gun. So this can be explained on the basis of Newton's third law of motion, because gun applies force on bullet in forward direction, that is action force, and due to reaction force which the bullet applies on the gun, this gun comes in backward direction. Now, even though the action and reaction forces are always equal in magnitude, these forces may not produce accelerations of equal magnitudes. Why? So, dear students, you must have studied in your earlier classes also that Earth is pulling us in downward direction. And now we have studied that if one object is applying force on another object, then another object will also apply the same force on the first object. It means we are also pulling the Earth towards us. But have you ever seen that Earth is falling on the person? Always, if a person jumps from a height, he falls towards the ground. But we never have seen Earth coming towards the person. So why it happens? Does it violate Newton's third law of motion? No. Actually, these all things are correct. We are also pulling Earth towards us. But what is happening? Let us understand it on the basis of Newton's second law of motion. As we know, according to Newton's second law, F is equal to ma. So A is equal to F by m, where A is acceleration produced in the object, F is force applied, external force applied, and m is mass of the object. We can see that acceleration is inversely proportional to the mass of the object. More is the mass, less will be acceleration produced. So Earth have very, very, very large mass as compared to the objects or persons which are situated on the surface of Earth. So acceleration produced in Earth is negligibly small. We cannot notice it. So students, if question is this, then answer you have to write in this way, that this is because each force acts on a different object and that may have different masses. Earth is applying force on us. We are applying force on Earth. So both objects are different. Now, question, same type of question. These question, all questions are given in your NCERT book, and I have tried to cover each and every line of your NCERT. That even though the action and reaction forces are always equal in magnitude, but acceleration produced in bullet is more as compared to gun. So students, you have noticed that bullet goes with a very high speed in forward direction, but gun do not come with the same speed as the bullet is going in backward direction. So why it happens? Same, we can explain it with the help of Newton's second law of motion. Also, it is suggested that while firing a bullet from the gun, then you should touch the gun with your shoulder. It is suggested to the soldiers or to the persons who are driving the gun. So why it is recommended? Reason is same, because when that gun is attached with your shoulder, then what happens? That your body mass is also add up with the mass of that gun, and the total mass of the system is increased. And as acceleration is inversely proportional to the mass, so mass of that gun have been increased because it is attached with your body. So acceleration produced by the gun means the speed with which the gun is coming back is decreased, and it will not hurt to your shoulder, it will not hurt to your body. Now another example of Newton's third law of motion, that tying of boat before allowing the passengers to get out of the boat. That you can see in this figure also, this is a boat and the person is coming out to this boat, and this is seashore or whatever. Okay, now this is suggested that this boat is tied to this seashore to some point when passenger is coming out to this boat. If it is not tied, then what will happen? That for coming out to this boat, this person will push the boat in backward direction. This boat will go in backward direction, and along with this boat, this person can also go in backward direction. It is very difficult to manage by this person to come out. So we tie this boat with the rope. So after tying this, the person can come out easily. So this is also on the basis of Newton's third law of motion. Next, swimming in water. Very interesting. Many of you must have observed this phenomena, and you have experienced this, that how you can swim. You push the water in backward direction, and according to Newton's third law of motion, water pushes your body in forward direction. So for every action, the reaction goes on and the person is swimming in the water. Harder the swimmer push the water with his hands and legs, faster he swims. The same thing, equal and opposite force, equal in magnitude. Harder he push means more force he is applying in backward direction, more reaction force he is getting in forward direction. Flying of a rocket. When a rocket is fired, the force of burning gas is coming out in downward direction. So it is made up in such a way that such type of fuel is placed here, so that when it is ignited, then large number of gases are produced, and these all gases are allowed to come in downward direction through a narrow hole, through a narrow nozzle. So these gases are coming out with a very large pressure, with a very large force in downward direction, and the rocket is going in upward direction due to the reaction force. In the same way, we can explain that jet aeroplanes are moving. They are pushing the gases in backward direction, and the jet aeroplanes are moving in forward direction. Also, some more phenomena, that when you are rowing the boat, then the person is having some sticks in his hands and he push the water in backward direction, and your boat is moving in forward direction. In the same way, flying of birds fly by exerting force on air, and the wings of bird force the air downwards and also backwards, and the air in return lifts the bird and also pushes it forward due to reaction force. So some more examples you can observe in your daily life. You must have seen sprinkler in your schools. So you must have seen that water is coming out in different directions and it is moving. Why it is moving? Because when water is coming from one direction, then he pushes that pipe which is in opposite direction, and it starts moving due to action and reaction pair of the forces. So Let us discuss now an experiment which shows Newton's third law of motion. For that, we will take two spring balloons A and B and we connect them with their ends. One end of B we will tie with this is some roof or a wall. This is fixed end. And another end of this A, it is movable. Now we will pull this A. We are applying force in this direction on A. So force applied on A in this direction, which will in turn pull B in this direction, and a reaction force is generated in B in opposite direction. So you can observe the same readings shown by A spring balance and B spring balance. So same reading shown by spring balance proves that the action force applied by A is equal to the reaction force applied by B. So this is also proving Newton's third law of motion. Now this is activity 9.4 given on page 123 of your NCERT, and there can be question in exam that prove Newton's third law of motion as well as Newton's second law of motion with the help of an activity. So you will read this activity from your book. I am explaining here that we will take two cards and two childs are standing on each card, one child on each card, and these cards are having some wheels also. We put some lines, some mark of the lines so that we can know the original position of these cards. Now these childs have some packet, okay, and they are playing. One child is throwing this packet to the other child. This child is picking up and again throwing to the first child. Again, first child is throwing to the second child, and so on. They are playing in this way. After some throw, if you will notice, their positions with respect to that initial line, then you will observe that their cards have been shifted away from that initial lines. So can you explain that why these have been shifted? Yes, on the basis of Newton's third law of motion, we can explain that when this child is throwing this packet to the other child, then he is applying force in forward direction to this packet. And due to the reaction force, this cart is moving in backward direction. In the same way, other child is also doing the same action. She is also throwing this packet to the first child, applying action force, and due to reaction force, this cart is moving in backward direction. And so after some throws, their actual respective positions with respect to the actual line have been shifted. Also, we can extend this activity by doing one more setting, that on one card we have two children. Now let we put one more children on this card and other card only one child, and still they again repeat this activity. Now they are throwing this packet to each other. Then what will you observe after some throw? You will observe that this cart, which is having two child, that cart have been shifted less as compared to the initial line as compared to the other child, which is having less marks on the card. Because one child means less marks, two child means more marks. Force applied on this bag is same by both child, but the mass on this cart is more. So by second law of motion, A is equal to F by M. More is mass on this cart, acceleration produced in backward direction is less. So less shifting will be observed by this cart as compared to this cart. So this another part of activity, prove second law of motion. Now this one more activity given on page 124, that when an air filled balloon is released, the force of air coming out of the balloon in left direction exerts an equal and opposite force on the balloon and it moves towards right. So you can do this activity at home. You will tie a thread, fix this thread to the two ends, and here is a straw pipe. You will bring this thread in between this straw pipe, and then you will fix a balloon on this straw pipe. Don't tie its end. Then when you are holding this balloon and it is inflated, when you will leave the mouth of this balloon, what you will observe? That the air from this balloon will come out in this direction, forward direction, we can say left direction in this figure. Then you will observe a shift in this system, in this balloon, in opposite direction, in backward direction, in right direction. This also proves Newton's third law of motion. So in exam, activities can be in the form of activity that prove by an activity Newton's third law of motion, or there can be question on the basis of those activities, that why it happens, then you have to explain that activity. So this activity we can explain on the basis of law of conservation of momentum also, and we can explain on the basis of Newton's third law of motion. Law of conservation of momentum we will study later on. So this was all about Newton's third law of motion. Study it and do the practice of the questions based on it. Thank you.